Hi everyone, welcome to today's tutorial. So in this tutorial we're going to be discussing this question here, which says determine the tension in the two ropes attached to the rigid supports in the system. If the supported blocks are in equilibrium, so if this block is in equilibrium with the tensions there, the first thing that we need to do is to write the free body diagram. So every time you have a question in physics, the most important thing you have to do before you even start solving that question is to write a free body diagram. Alright, so let's quickly do that. So if you have not yet subscribed to the channel, make sure that you click the subscription button down there so that you don't miss out the videos I'm going to be posting. Yeah, the solutions to questions I'm going to be posting. Alright, so let's quickly do the question. So the free body diagram for this one is going to be, we have this force which is 100 newtons. So we have this force which is 100 newtons. So we make an assumption that all the forces are moving away from the joint. Okay, let me write it properly. Then we have this other force going this side. So I'll call it T1. This one is 100 newtons. Then I also have T2. So what we are going to do to solve this question, we're going to resolve all these tensions into components. And how do we do that? So I'll take the first one here. I'll find the X and the Y component for T1. So if I get the first one, I've been given the angle, which is 45 there. So this 45 is making a Z angle with that 45. So I'm going to have 45 there. So I'm going to draw a triangle, which is going to be like that. So the hypotenuse is T1. The adjacent to the angle 45 is the x component of T1. Then the opposite will be the Y component of T1. Yeah, so we also draw this second triangle. So we have this one is facing this side. So let me also draw the second triangle, which is just this side. Then the angle is there. So with this triangle, I have the forces, the tension direction is this one that we've taken. So this means that we're going to have the X component of this T2 in this direction, then the Y component of T2 going up the positive Y axis. Then since the angle here is 60, means that this angle is 30. Because when you add all the internal angles of a triangle, it's supposed to add up to 180. Alright, so let's begin to do the summation. So let's find the summation of forces in the X. Summation of forces in the X should equal to 0. Sum applies to summation of forces in the Y. It's also supposed to equal to 0. So let's start with the X. So in the X, we have the X component of T1. So in the X, we have the X component of T1 and the X component of T2. So the X component of T1 from Sokatoa, we know to say Sokatoa. So from Sokatoa, we have X component of T1 is the adjacent. So if this is the adjacent and then this is the hypotenuse, it means that we're using cos. So if we're using cos, we're going to have something like this. I want to say cos 45 is equal to cos 45 is equal to the adjacent, which is the X component of T1 over the hypotenuse, which is T1. So if we make X component of T1 the subject by cross multiplying, we want to have the X component of T1 to be equal to T1 times cos 5, which is just T1 cos 45. So the first one I'm going to have is T1 cos 45. Then also have this one which is facing towards the negative. So I'm going to add a negative. So this one here is facing towards the negative. So I'll add the negative sign. And then it's also an adjacent to the angle. So if I'm using this angle, if I'm using 60, it means that this will be opposite. So I should use sine. But in case I'm using, I mean, in this case, I'm using it as an adjacent to 30. So if it's adjacent, I'll still use cos. So this will be minus T2 cos for cos 30 rather. Okay. Then these are the only x components that we have. So we say this should be equal to 0. Then we make one of these tensions the subject. So I can make T1 the subject. This will be T2 cos 30 divided by cos 45. So T1 will therefore be equal to, we say cos 30 divided by cos 45. Cos 30 divided by cos 45. Which is about 1.2247. So we have 1.2247 T2. So let us also do the same in the y. So summation of forces in the y should also equal to 0. And the forces that we have in the y, we have this 100 newtons, which is pointing towards the negative y. Then we also have the y component of T2. Y component of T2, this is facing towards the positive, so it's a T2. Since in the X, T2 was cos, we used cos 30. So in the Y component will be sine 30. And then the Y component of T1 is also facing up, which is this one here. So it's opposite to 45, so meaning we're using the opposite and the hypotenuse, which is sine. Let me say all these are supposed to give you 0, since there is an equilibrium condition there. So we take this 100 to the other side of the cosine, then we replace where there's T1 by this, because we know that T1 is equal to that. So we say T2 sine 30 plus where there's T1, I'm going to put that, which will be 1.2247 T2, and then times sine 30. So we say this is equal to 100. So now what we do here is we multiply this and that. Then after doing the multiplication, then we add the resulting resulting figures. So we have sine 30, which is just 0.5 T2. Then plus, when we multiply this and that, the answer will be it's supposed to be 45, not 30, because we're dealing with T1. So when you're dealing with T1, we have the angle 45 there. Okay, so we say 1.2247 times sine 45. And then when you find that, you add it to 0.5. So we have, when you multiply these two, we are getting something like 0.8659 T2 is equal to 100. So when you add the two, you are getting something like 1.3. 65, let me just say 1.366, T2 is equal to 100. So when you divide everything by that, the value of T2 becomes, when you divide 100 by that, the answer will be 73.2 newtons, of course. Then we find T1 by replacing the answer there. So T1 will therefore be equal to, let me just erase this part. So T1 will therefore be equal to 1.2247 times T2. So T2 is 73.2. So our T1 will also be equal to, so we're multiplying that. Which gives us 89.65. Gives us 89.65 newtons. Alright, so this is, so let me say 6.66, because when you round this off, corrects to two decimal places, it'll be 66. So 89.66 newtons. So these are the answers that you were requested to find. See you in the next tutorial video. Make sure that you don't forget to subscribe to the channel. My name is Harmtedy.